Today we're heading back to the Tower of Babel. Now that we've got the seeds, hopefully we can continue our quest to find the fortune teller. What she's doing up there is anyone's guess. What's up there is anyone's guess. And the caterpillar will not be coming with us. Yeah, I think we saw this coming. We'll see him or her a bit later. We gotta get to the top of the tower, but unfortunately, the express elevator is out of order. Fortunately, or unfortunately, depending on how you look at it, we have a bunch of puzzle-laden floors, I should say, that we could take instead. Oh, joy. I don't know if they plan this to be some sort of weird religious ritual to earn your way to the top. They make it pretty clear. They want you to... The top was supposed to be above this. It's supposed to be heaven. Yeah, I don't know how they pinpointed it so well, but whatever. Hang on. I think the sword's swinging too fast. Leviathan's really useful in that it makes the sword throw faster. I don't think it charges any faster, but it goes farther and it moves faster. Unfortunately, I needed to slow it down for that particular puzzle. This one's pretty simple. Just hit the little green thing until he cuts his way through the entire floor. Problem being that you can't really tell where he's going to go. Best thing to do is put the Leviathan back on and throw your sword from a distance. It's just unfortunate that it takes two hits, but just a time killer. Again, one of the nice things about having a Leviathan on is you can throw the sword so far. Okay, and see. Okay, Ella makes his floors up. Let's see what we got there. Okay, conveyor belts and green pop-up thingies. Despite the fact they look like the monster from the previous room. Nah, you just gotta kill these or knock them out of the way. This one here, you want to hit the bottom one. That way you can kind of catch yourself on that top one. And to the next floor. No real puzzle here, you just gotta brute force your way. Put on Leviathan, smash the hell out of all the boxes, and clear a path. There is no way, at least no way I've found, to avoid letting some of these out. The best you can do is only let one or two of them out. I think two minimum. Okay, next puzzle. Bouncy things. Jump on the right one. And voila. Simple, right? Okay, find the tile that's different on the right side and then jump on it. You guess this one? Good job. Okay, another fuse puzzle. As I mentioned before, the training course explains how these work, even though that one in the desert, to my knowledge, doesn't work like this. You actually have to have the fuses next to each other, the red blocks on those. Here, however, you can use these blue blocks to make a long fuse and basically burn the rest of them out. And they're nice enough to include three of them. That way, in case you screw up, as I often do, well, you don't have to reset the entire room. We have plenty of boxes to move, no reason to move anymore, and we just have to. But as a kid, I was always sort of obsessive compulsive. I'd have to use every single block. I don't know. I guess my parents just really reinforced the clean my room aspect. Okay, next one. You can't tell, but you're sliding to the top. Kind of brute force my way through this one. I find jumping helps, though. It's not too hard. Another simple one. Basically just a Leviathan so you can swing fast and cut your way through quick before those things pop back up and start hurting you. I said puzzles, didn't I? Not really. Well, it's something, I suppose. Okay, this is what I like to call the simplest block pushing puzzle. You can probably tell why if you played any Zelda game or any game where block pushing is a feature. Okay, the only difference here is they make you do it so many times in a row. As a kid, again, I always pushed them all the way down. Waste of time. Okay, there's really nothing blocking you here. You just gotta know where those paths are and just jump carefully to make sure you don't hit the slidey parts. And there we are, we're finally at the top. Gonna plant the seeds, and voila. A Mario-esque vine that leads us straight up to heaven. Up and up and up. One thing I gotta say though, I really like the music in this sector. It's very spooky. Kind of gets that church feel, I suppose. And it's actually the same music from the church in the town of Soleil. A lot of flowers here. You see they all... It's kind of neat the way they kind of start bouncing behind you. Let's see, you got... Okay, I didn't even realize. Yeah, I'm talking to the humans here, but everyone can talk to everyone here. What John Lennon's got to say. Sing on. Let's see. Depressing, but well, you think she'd be a little happier if she's in heaven. I mean, nice enough place. They got their tiny little halos and they're kind of flying. I kind of like having a name, to be honest. Ah, this is the husband of the lady from the Dahlia Valley, the one who was being terrorized by the big bonked wolf. And... oh boy. That's gonna be fun. Well, let's just not worry about that just yet. Let's keep moving. I don't want to talk to everyone here. Strange, no one's mentioned the fortune teller yet. Oh. Let's see, going here, and... yeah, really no point to cutting the grass. There's not any really coins here. I could have sworn there's some money around here, but I don't know. Is that everybody? That's everybody. Okay. Well, sometimes you just gotta follow the path, you know? So, before we go on... oh, yeah, I guess we should check over here, too, just to be sure. Nope, another chicken. I think they actually do use the line that he doesn't have to worry about becoming fried chicken in the American version. And now for the flowers, which... oh boy. I tell you what, I'll go ahead and do this off screen so you don't have to watch me go over every flower. Oh, that was fun. Ugh, this hurts my eyes and it's probably going to do hell on the rendering, but... oh well. It's done. And, the flowers are all happy. I've hopefully made this woman happy, and she will give me a prize, which I believe to be a golden apple. Every little bit of help helps, especially when you forget to save as often as I do. Oh no. I must have missed one. You know what? I'm not gonna do the... I'll do it off camera. I'll go ahead and cut it off right here. See you next time.